All right, and welcome to Experiment 3, learning how to do a melting point. So in this part of our demonstration, you should have already watched the recrystallization video. That'll be kind of the first step in the process. Now that we've gotten our purified product after the recrystallization video, we're ready to take it on to analysis. So we're going to learn how to do a melting point analysis on our unknown solid. So when doing a melting point determination, you can follow along on the PowerPoint that goes through some of the steps, as you can see here. So make sure to look through that as you're going through the video. The major pieces you're going to need to do this is a watch glass full of your unknown, and then melting point capillaries. These are just tiny little glass tubes, closed on one end, open on the other. And then you'll actually need the melting point apparatus itself. So the ones you're using should look like this. It's a much more modern version. It's electronic, so it's programmable. But also available and probably much more common are melting point apparatuses that look like this. These have kind of a manual dial, so the temperature increase is not digitally controlled. It's a little bit tougher, so we have the luxury of using the programmable ones, but using an apparatus like this works the exact same way. So when starting out, all the operating instructions are clearly listed on the front of the machine. So I'll briefly walk through those steps, but if ever you forget, then just review these procedural steps that are listed out there. So the first thing to do is fill a melting point capillary with your solid. So here's a melting point capillary closed on this end and then open on the other. So you're going to take that open end and then fill it up by dabbing it into your solid on the watch glass. So what you should end up with is the solid filling just barely a little bit of the tip of that capillary. So once it's filled, you're going to take a glass rod, looks like this, it's just open, and then you're going to take this closed end down and drop it into this glass rod. So by doing that, you're going to pack your solid down to the bottom closed end. So run through that a few times, and then in the end you should have your solid down at the closed end ready for melting point analysis. You don't want to fill it up very high. You want a nice small amount so that it melts consistently. So once you've filled up your capillary tube, or if you have multiple capillary tubes, three can actually be run in this machine at the same time, you want to actually turn on the Meltemp. So you'll turn that on a switch at the back left corner. The first thing you want to do is set your start temperature and your stop temperature. Since my compound in this melting point capillary has a melting point of 159 degrees, I want to kind of pick a range about 20 degrees below and then maybe 5 degrees above. So I'll take my start temperature, melting point's 159, and I'll start it 20 degrees below that. So 139. Once I've set it, I click the start temp again. And then the stop temp, I just want 5 degrees above, so I'll go 164. And then press the stop temp again. The ramp rate, you can select 2 degrees per minute, and you can also select 5 degrees per minute. By selecting the 5 degrees per minute, you run a much greater chance of missing the melting point. So to be safe, since it's only going to take 10 or 12 minutes, I'm just going to stay with the 2 degrees Celsius per minute ramp. So that means every minute it's going to raise 2 degrees from 139 all the way up to 174, or 164, sorry. So once you set your start, stop, and ramp, you're going to click the start stop button right here. So when you click that, it's going to start preheating the oven. So it's going to take a while for that to warm up and preheat. And then in a minute we'll come back and we'll see the ready button will be lit. So you can see we're up to our start temperature, 139. The ready light is green. And so at this point we're ready to insert our samples into one of the three holes up here at the top. So I put my sample right in there. There's two other spots where I could run up to three samples at once if I needed to. So once you've inserted your sample, then you can press the start stop and it will begin that ramp. So at this point I see my first drop of liquid, so I want to come over and press the number 2. That records that temperature, and then wait till it melts all the way. At this point the sample's all liquid, so I again hit number 2, and then once the process has stopped I want to come over and click start stop, and that will start cooling down the apparatus. So once it's cooling I can click on the number 2 and get my recorded values. So the beginning of my melting point range was 155, the end was 160.7. So I've got my range, and then I can go back and analyze based on the literature value, which for my case was 159, why that range might be broad, if it's low, why it might be low, and that'll give me some idea, not only the identity, but the purity of my product as well. So that's melting point analysis. Remember, this is just a physical property, so it's a rough way to determine the identity and also the purity of an organic compound. Later on we'll learn much more sophisticated techniques, but for doing something like this lab, this is a quick and easy way to assess identity and purity. So hopefully that worked well, and I'll see you later.